When you convert your database schema from one engine to another, you also convert the extract, transform, and load processes. You can use the AWS Schema Conversion Tool to convert Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services ETL packages. AWS SCT version 1.0.661 supports the conversion of SSIS packages to AWS Glue and AWS Glue Studio. This video shows how to create a new AWS SCT project, convert your source SSIS packages, review them in AWS Glue Studio, and verify the conversion. Launch the AWS Schema Conversion Tool and create a new project. Enter a name of the project and location to save a local project file. Next, add Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services as a source. Enter the path to the folder where you store your source SSIS packages. Add AWS Glue Studio as a migration target. AWS SCT connects to AWS Glue Studio using your AWS credentials. You can store your AWS credentials in the AWS SCT Global Application Settings. After AWS SCT connects to AWS Glue Studio, create a mapping rule. A mapping rule defines your source and target platforms. Choose your source SSIS script in the AWS Glue Studio target and then choose Create Mapping. Switch to the main view. The source metadata tree includes your SSIS package. This demo POC1 component includes a connection manager, data flow task, two sources, one target, and a merge join transformation component. SSIS packages interact with a database, which is specified in their connection manager component. Your converted AWS Glue Studio jobs will also interact with your new target database. Because of that, specify an AWS Glue Studio connection for all your source SSIS connections. Make sure that you have already created all required AWS Glue Studio connections. Now, all is set to start the conversion. After you convert your source SSIS packages, AWS SCT creates objects in the target tree. The target metadata tree includes AWS Glue Studio objects such as connections, crawlers, databases, ETL jobs, and triggers. AWS SCT converts SSIS packages to the objects that have a directed acyclic graph structure. Find the converted objects in the DAGs node, review the converted code, and make changes, if needed. Save the converted files to Amazon S3 and configure your AWS Glue Studio jobs. On the first step of the wizard, edit the basic job properties, such as name, script file name, and job parameter values. On the second step, edit the advanced job properties, such as IAM role, script file S3 path, and so on. Make sure that you specify the IAM role with permissions to run AWS Glue Studio jobs. Configure all job properties and choose Finish to create AWS Glue Studio jobs. Find these jobs in the ETL jobs node of the target metadata tree. These jobs include scripts with required parameters which you specified in the wizard. Create the AWS Glue Studio jobs for your configured ETL jobs. The Apply Status tab displays the status of the AWS Glue Studio job creation. Open AWS Glue Studio and refresh the list of jobs. The list includes all three jobs from AWS SCT. The AWS Glue Studio job includes a visual representation of the Glue Studio job pipeline and the generated script. Because SSIS components have different features compared to AWS Glue Studio, the converted jobs may include more components than your source SSIS packages. Now, you can run your AWS Glue Studio job. The job status changes to succeeded. Our job repopulates data in the account customer table. We can see that this table includes 15 data rows. Our source SSIS script produced the same output. This means that AWS SCT correctly converts SSIS packages to AWS Glue Studio. Now you can use the converted script with your new target database in the cloud. This completes the overview of the SSIS packages to AWS Glue Studio jobs conversion and AWS SCT. Thanks for watching this video.